Welcome to SNIS Mobile Studio with SciComm 2019. Is this your first participation at a ScienceComm?
No, it isn't. I'm also part of the program organization teams. And I'm in connection with all the colleagues who are working for the universities of all the institutions of higher education, innovation and research.
So what are your impressions about this edition of ScienceComm?
Yes, what's really difficult for communications is that we have now an abundance of channels and contact points with the public, with all the people interested in science. And it's rather hard to find a way to all those people. And yesterday somebody mentioned it's so tough to reach the younger generation. We know they are interested, but they are like fast-moving targets, one day on this platform, the other day on the other social platform, and that's really a big challenge.
Could you give us a couple of elements of your professional background and how what you are doing as head of communication fits with the global mission of Swiss Universities organization?
Okay, my personal background, I'm a sociologist in cultural studies, and I was always interested in the way societies create the possibility for creativity. And science and teaching is for me a kind of creativity, as is movie making, arts, or education. So, and for me, the big issue is how do you really enable people to be creative? And yes, in the end, that's also my personal mission, my personal motivation to work in this organization. Swiss Universities is a political institution. It's the umbrella institution of all Swiss institutions of higher education and universities. It's the former Rector's Conference. So we are in touch with the law. We have a legal mandate and with all the administration, federal administration, who found all those institutions. And therefore it's very important to have a legitimation, not only with the administrative people who have to prepare the decision, but also with all the citizens who in the end will vote about how much money will be contributed to universities.
So this legitimation mission that you have, what type of material does communication towards that, is it based on?
Okay, material is one thing. I would prefer to talk about an attitude. And the attitude is also a kind of gratitude that the public is really ready to put so much money in universities and research. And we are very lucky in Switzerland because we have really a huge acceptance of the whole domain of education and research. And the attitude is also you don't have to take it for granted. And this humility is something, yes, that wasn't always part of the cultural habitus of the science community, but I'm very happy to realize that it's part now of all the members of the science community. We don't have this attitude anymore. We are the ones who know. And you are the one you have to teach, and if you don't understand, it's your fault.
So you talk about a change in attitude, which is a way of measuring impact of the communication efforts of the institution. Can you tell us more about this and maybe about the obstacles that were encountered in this process?
Yes, one of the obstacles is overcoming the fear of transparency. And transparency is one of the key trigger of the development of recent communication and information. So the public now wants institutions to put on the table all their cards and to answer all the questions. So, yes, in the last century, it was, you could just say, oh, that's our secret, and we know, and we have like a paternalistic attitude. But the trigger of transparency is very challenging, because you have to put on the table also your problems. And when something doesn't work, or when you don't yet have the answers to certain questions. And that's a whole different question in communication.
So what have you learned in the course of deploying this mission in communication?
Yes, what I have learned is must be a priority. So communication, if you have... It is taking the point of view from the outside and overcoming this inner circle, group thinking dynamics. And I think communication should be somebody with this role, with this perspective, should sit on the table always. And all the decision makings have to be aware that the questions that the communications people are putting them, that will be the questions they have to answer to the whole public also.
And for a more conclusive question, in the field of communication about science, are there elements you would like to see more of or less of?
Okay, the people, one thing is very important. We have this academic freedom. But this academic freedom is also academic responsibility. And we should have a critical discourse about people in the academic sector who misuse the academic freedom for their personal purposes. That's a really big challenge also.
Josefa Haas, thank you very much for your being here, and good luck with the rest of the conference.